If you've been around the channel for any amount of time, then you know that the Air Jordan 1 is my favorite sneaker of all time. Also, you know that the Air Jordan 1 Mid gets absolutely no love from me. However, now we have the Air Jordan 1 Low making a comeback. I don't know what I'm supposed to feel, but I think I like it. Jason, where from?
These niggas be talking about me like they know me. Look. You turned your back on me, dude ain't my homie. But fuck what they say, cause I had to keep going. I'm facing
like hide,
I could've been gone. The bitch alive, she wanted me only. I ain't surprised, don't wanna know why. My head to the sky, my heart on its corner. I'm from the north, I cut that shit short. I pray to the Lord, back then I was homeless.
What up YouTube, it's your boy the Cardboard Collector, aka the GOAT, aka Mr. Sneaker Trapper, aka Sneaker Trapper of the Year. Every damn year. And I am back again today, man, with another video for you. And I know you guys are probably looking around and saying like, yo, dude is kicking it up a notch. Like, yes, I have been truly getting to it. I mean, you can see your boy needs a haircut and everything like that, but I gotta keep the fresh shit coming. I know I promised that I would be here a little bit more, you know, try to make a few more videos, and I appreciate everyone who has, you know, been like hitting me up and saying like, yo, the videos are fire, like we fuck with you, underrated. Like, I see all those comments and I appreciate that. We got a little bit of a different video today, guys. I know a lot of you probably caught the vid I did a few weeks back about the Air Jordan 1 Low making a comeback, and how, you know, we're starting to see all of these Air Jordan 1 Low releases in both men's and women's. You know, we're getting some crazy stuff. We haven't really gotten any of that collab shit yet, but we are getting, you know, way more Air Jordan 1 Lows than we've been getting in previous years. This particular video came from that Jordan 1 Low vid because I got someone that reached out to me and actually wanted to see a specific Air Jordan 1. Now, the cool thing about this Air Jordan 1 is that it has not actually released in the United States yet. At this moment, it has only released over in Europe and Japan. So it took a little bit of difficulty for your boy to actually get it in to do this video. But of course, I made it happen. And we're gonna take a look at that. But before we do that, go ahead and do that shit that your boy like, man. Hit that subscribe button. Make sure you like and comment down below. Let us know what you want to see. Let us know what you want to hear from us. And we'll make sure we get on top of that. And as always, sharing is caring. The Air Jordan 1 Low Reverse Bread. I got to tell you, man, when I got the request for this sneaker and I realized that it wasn't out in the U.S. and I was going to have to put forth the effort that I did in order to obtain this sneaker, I almost was just like, I'm not doing all of that for a low. Like, I'm so happy that I did. Like, legitimately, this is probably going to be one of my favorite sneakers or favorite releases of all of 2020. The quality on this sneaker, man, is like beyond anything that I have seen recently from Jordan brand. And I was actually surprised that I was able to, you know, grab it for the price that I was. But I guess, you know, the Air Jordan 1 Low phase hasn't quite hit yet. As you can see, this is my personal size, men's 13. As I stated, this sneaker has not released in the U.S. yet. So we have, like, this was in the box. I don't know if you guys can see it, but I'll give you a close-up. Because it is all in, like, Japanese. There is no English on this paper. This came in a box. Like, we don't get any shit like this in, like, the U.S. So I don't know what it says. I don't know what it means. But it's got a lot of pictures on it and a whole lot of, like, Japanese letters. I do know that as of July 1st, they were postponed and pushed back again. There has not been anything set in the U.S. I'm not actually sure exactly why, but I'm pretty sure it's got something to do with the world just being a serious mess right now. And at some point, we should probably get a release date here in the U.S. And at that point, I will be doubling up. There are no Nike Air brandings on this sneaker. So, of course, you do have, you know, your Jumpman logo here on the tongue. And, man, that tongue is... that tongue has got a lot of padding in it. I like that tongue's giving me like serious SB vibes. But you got your Jordan brand logo here on the tongue. And then, of course, on the back, you have your Air Jordan 1 Wings logo, which is stitched in. And it mostly, for the most part, is always stitched in on the lows. Looking at the back of this shoe, man, and I will make sure you guys get a very good close-up of right here. Because, like, each layer, the quality of the stitching on this shoe is better than a lot of the shit I've seen, like, in a long time. This shoe is actually, like, really, really nice in person and really, really good in hand. So shout out to the guy who requested this video. Like, I'm all for it. I, like, hopefully you see this and it was what you thought it was supposed to be, because To me, this shit is banging. Looking at it a little more in depth here, of course, you've got the Black Tongue with the Red Jumpman, as we just stated, going down with some black laces. This did not come with any additional laces. I mean, I don't know if there's going to be a separate thing for, you know, like the U.S. release, but this one only came with the black laces. There was nothing else with it. Of course, everything here, you know, as it is a reverse bread, then there is, you know, the red where it would normally be black. And I got to tell you, man, like this part of the shoe right here, you can see like the leather quality. This is like, I would honestly love to have Jordan 1's old, like OG highs in this type of quality. Like, I don't think, I mean, I would be willing, like, if anyone else can touch this or anyone else has seen this, let me know. Like, I'm starting to think this is possibly one of the best Jordan leather qualities I've seen in all Jordan 1. This shit is like 94 Jordan 1 leather quality. This shoe is probably, I can tell you now, like, I am going to put some serious miles on this sneaker. Like, you'll probably see me, like, snapping it up on Instagram in these, like, tomorrow. This shoe is that damn fire. As I stated, nothing crazy on the back, just the Air Jordan 1 Wings logo. You do have a white midsole, which is normally what you're gonna get on most bread colorways. I've honestly, you know, reverse bread or you know, regular bread or Chicago's or whatever, you normally get a white midsole. Of course, you've got a red sole on the bottom here, standard Air Jordan 1 sole, nothing real crazy to talk about there. I mean, the leather quality of this shoe is probably the biggest selling point. I will honestly tell you guys that, you know, I'm willing to compare this. If I have to, I'll do a comparison video and we can line this up against like any Air Jordan 1 that you guys want to see. Like, drop it down in the comments. I'm willing to place my money on this. Looking here on the inside, of course, you've got your black here around the collar on the inside of the shoe. It's got a black insole. I'll get those out. Make sure you guys get pictures of those. Again, this tongue is super padded. I haven't, you know, I don't remember seeing this on any of like the OG highs and definitely not on any of the lows that I have, but this is a quality shoe. This is premium material. This sneaker is worth every penny that I spent on. Easily, this is a double up. This is a shoe that I can see myself wearing and, you know, being pissed off that it's old and I can't get another one because I'm still wearing my 2013 Bread 1 lows. So I wear those probably, you know, I don't know. I put those on probably once a week. It's very comfortable, you know, cool shoe for like summer. And, you know, I could easily see myself replacing those with these. That kind of wraps it up for today, guys. Like, honestly, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I would love to do a whole lot more reviews of things you guys want to see, like reviews of. I know that some of you have already started to ask for another Amazon sneaker purchase. So that will probably be coming. But when we look at this Air Jordan 1, like, I'm so happy that someone requested this because this sneaker will probably be my favorite shoe for the next couple of months. I seriously plan on putting a lot of miles on this, and maybe I'll check back in with you guys and let you know, like, you know, what it looks like after it's been broken in, kind of worn a little bit. But honestly, man, let me know what you think. Are you here for the Air Jordan 1 low phase? Are you, you know, are you going to skip this wave? You know, we got Air Force Ones, we got Dunks, we got other lifestyle sneakers that are out there. But I honestly really, really like this shoe. Let me know what you think. I'm out.
Always been me. What I know. These niggas hating, I ain't too blind for the sea. Keep shit in line, I'm like the two lines in the street. I got that nine and I ain't too high, it's in reach. Don't play with me, I'm out that three. It's gonna be sad cases. Been in my bag lately.